Hey folks, welcome to the third and final round. This hand looks a lot like the one type of hand we've seen lose from this deck, in that that it only has the one land there, which is unfortunate. Probably need more than that. Why not scry towards a red source, or I suppose a two drop that can crew freighters. All right, you can just go up the vehicle train, assume that welder gets to stick around for a bit. Welder crew freighter, freighter crew crusher, crusher crew opponent's facer, maybe. Opponent also took a mulligan. Not looking to trade two drops. Especially because we have a tampering, so if we had a red source off the top, we can pop Cobra. Yeah, you got me. Interesting. It's a little aggressive, because if we kept the counter on the Seed Sculptor instead of pumping the freighter, then if they had some way of killing the welder, then we'd still have a creature that could crew freighter. Really looking for a red source off the top to pop Cobra, keep on serving in. Maybe we just accept the trade. Opponent leaving four white up, or I'm sorry, four mana up is troublesome. Could mean all kinds of terrible things are about to happen to my attack step here. But I don't think I can just sit back, rest on my laurels. Laurels are pretty uncomfortable for the most part. Awesome. That was kind of what I was hoping was going to happen that combat. I was hoping for no tricks. Even like Blinking Leopard with the two and a white, flicker one of my creatures cards. Even Blinking Leopard to block Welder would have been pretty brutal there. So the opponent could burn us for this line if they go like five draw up into, or if they play the 5/4 that gains five life when it comes into play. But I think that's one of the few things that does. Getting the opponent down to one when we have like double welder with a red source to activate one of them is a pretty strong play for the most part, I think. Putting them to dead next turn. I suppose there's also the 3-mana 2/2 uncommon from Kaladesh that gains 2 life. Overall, not a ton. Or like Appetite, because they are playing green, gain 2 life. Answer one of the welders. The thing about that, though, is then the opponent is still so low that they can't really attack me and pressure my life total. And then we just say, okay, whatever, play our Crusher, get mana for Tusker, win that way. Have time to develop. So it seemed all right. It was either win the game immediately, or the opponent plays one of kind of a narrow range of cards to stall for a bit, and then they're still on the defensive because we got so much damage in. And most of the cards that I listed off there are uncommons. So there's that as well. All right, well, at this point, I've talked about it enough that my eyes have glazed over, and I'm no longer even looking at my sideboard. I'm not sure if those cards even exist at this point. Schrodinger's sideboard. Could maybe like try and focus. Check out the individual cards. Oh man, this hand would be so good with a second land. I think some people would still keep this, even with the new scry rule. I think some people would still keep this hand because we have two mana dorks. So we're going turn two mana dork, and then, oh man, could have the turn three boar, living the dream. Well, I'm afraid I'm going to be a boar because I'm not going to do anything nearly that exciting. Let's go six. Sure. Keep scry towards this. Oh, hey, a turn three boar hand. Turn three boar, turn four tusker. Seems like it could be pretty good. Pretty all right. This is better than I usually do with red-green. I actually think the last video set that I did for channel was also red-green, and it was like a draft that didn't go very well. And then I drafted like maybe one red-green deck in between and like my tens and tens of drafts in this format. I've drafted like a ton of white-black interaction. Hidden Stockpile is probably my favorite card in the set. If you get multiples of that card, it's just so much fun. And then these wonky black engine decks. Opponent's having a rough time over there. Looks like they're missing a Landorino. I'm considering just playing Tampering, running out the Druid next turn, so I have one more creature to get the Tusker bonus. That might be too cute, though, because the Tusker gets quite a bit of power in play, just by nature of being a 5/5 in and of itself. Then we have this Tampering, and yeah, it's just better, I think. That +3/+3 card could blow me out here, though. Like, if they pump the Cobra, I would be trading with Boar. Whereas if we Tampering, kill Cobra, play Druid, attack for 4, that's still a fine line. Opponent's thinking. If they do have the +3/+3 card, I don't see how they can win this game. Oh, it's not the +3/+3 card. Okay, that's worth thinking about. That's totally legit. That is totally legit. Yeah, I like it. Well, I'm kind of glad I didn't go for the Tampering. Get blown out by Blossoming, like not even get any damage in. Lose my Tampering. That all sounds bad. If I'd wanted to attack with Servant here, I think I would have had to use Destructive. So the Tusker can still crew Crusher. It just can't attack or block itself. Okay, well now I just want to blank attack with Servant. If they want to double block it, that's cool. By blank attack, I just mean that I'm not tampering the the automaton first to prevent a double block. Because this way we would be converting 3 power into 2 power anyway, so trading for the leopard is absolutely acceptable. And then Tusker is still there to crew the Crusher next turn. An opponent kind of needs to play a removal spell on the cavalry, because otherwise we're going to have lethal unblockable. I guess they could play a flyer, technically. Even that doesn't seem super exciting. And I think they're just too far behind. Day late and a dollar short. Maybe even $2 at this point. Yeah, this deck felt sweet. This is sweeter, much sweeter than my average red-green deck. It really came together. Win pack 3 kind of like fixed our curve, gave us some neat tools to work with. It's another powerful red-green uncommon. The red-green uncommons kind of rewarded us for staking out our path kind of early on. Super aggressive too. Yeah, that deck was hotter than a $2 pistol. I loved it. All right, well, maybe I'll draft red-green more often. Well, good luck to everybody in your Aether Revolt drafts. I'm still enjoying the format. I think it's one of my top 5 favorite limited formats ever. I've been drafting it a lot. Yeah, not much else to see. Say, see you all next week. We'll be right back.